Good morning to everyone. In this session, we are going to discuss about the topic of perceptron networks, adaptive linear neuron, multiple adaptive linear neuron. So first, we are going to discuss about perceptron networks briefly. So coming to the point of perceptron, it is first developed by Frank Rosenwald by using Mikulacz and Pitts model. The perceptron's basic unit, it is an operational unit of artificial neural networks. It follows a supervised learning rule to classify the data into two classes. How about the operational characteristics of perceptron is, it consists of a single neuron with arbitrary number of inputs with adjustable weights, and then the output of the neuron is 1 and 0, depends upon the threshold. So it consists of the bias weight, which will be always 1. So Anand, this is about the architecture of the perceptron network. So in this architecture, this is about the input layer, and then this is the summation of adder. Along with that, this is the bias input which you have fed to the adder. So after that, all the values summing it up, it will be passing to the activation function. So once it is performed the activation function, it will be checking with the threshold value. So if it is matched with the threshold value, so the output will be obtained. Output will be obtained, and then it will be checking of the errors or there are not. So if there is, the output is not matched with the targeted output, so then we need to find out the deviation of or the difference with the output with the actual target output. So then we need to adjust the weight in the input layer. So in the each input which you are giving at the input layer, the weight will be feeding to the network. So all will be summing up in the adder. So in the bias, the input will be passed as 1. After summing it up, it will be passed to the activation function, and then the output will be obtained. So we'll be matching with the target output. If it is matched, then it will be accepted. So this is about the perceptron schematic architecture. So and then we have three basic elements for perceptrons, that is links, adder, and then activation function. So how about the link is, we have a set of connection links, so which carries a weight to the network, including the bias. So bias will be always setting as 1, which I have told you already in the previous slide. So in the adder, the work of the adder is to add the input, so when they are multiplied with their respective weight. So that's the work of the adder. And then the activation function is, it limits the output of the neuron. And then the most basic activation function is Heaviside step function, which has two possible outputs. So it will be returning 1 if the input is positive, and then if the it will be returning a 0 if the if you are giving as a negative input. So this is about the three basic elements of the perceptron. And then this is the next we are going to see about the perceptron training algorithm. So in the perceptron training algorithm, we have several steps to be getting followed. So in the step 1, we need to initialize the following to start the training, that is weight, bias, and then learning rate of alpha. We need to produce it. We need to initialize it. So for our easy calculation, we always need to set the weight and bias to be as a 0 in the initial state, and then the learning rate should be equal to 1. So in the step 2, we need to continue the step from 3 to 8 until the further condition, stopping condition, is not true. And then in step 3, we need to continue the steps 4 to 6 for every training vector of x. And then in step 4, we need to activate the each input unit as x of I equal to s of I, where I equal to 1 to n. And then for the step 5, how to obtain the input vector with the following relation is y input equal to b plus summation of I equal to n x of I and then w of I. This is the formula to calculate the input vector. And then from the step 6, we need to apply the above activation function to obtain the final output. So the activation function y f of y in equal to 1 if the function is of y input is greater than theta. So and then the function will be returning 0 if minus of theta is less than or equal to y in less than or equal to theta. and minus 1 if y input of y input is less than minus theta. So after in the step 6, in step 7 we need to adjust the weight and bias. So that what we have did here in the in case 1, if y is not equal to t, then we need to follow this formula: w of i of nu equal to w of i of old plus alpha of t xi. So this is the formula to calculate the weight of new weight, and then the bias is also new. So b of nu equal to b of old plus alpha of t. So in similarly in the case 2, if y is equal to t, then this formula we need to follow: w of i of nu equal to w of i of old, that is a new weight equal to the old weight, and then new bias equal to the old bias. So where y is the actual output and t is the desired or targeted output. So and then what's a training algorithm we will be using for multiple output units mentioned here in this slide. So this is a network for the multiple output units. Here in this slide we have mentioned the input vectors as x denoted, x1, x of j, and then up to of x of n, and then the output units are y of i, y of j, and y of n. So this is about the multiple output units network. So where the weight is propagated through the network, and then the same work which we seen in the perceptron, the output which you are getting at the output layer should be matched with the targeted output. If not, we need to adjust the weight at the input layer. So this is what the general concept which is applied to all the neural networks. So in step 1 we need to initialize the following to start our training: weight, bias, and the learning rate of alpha. And then for our easy calculation, we need to set the weight and bias to be as 0, and then learning rate should be as equal to 1. And step 2, we need to continue the steps from step 3 to 8. And then up to that, the condition is not true, we need to continue it. And then step 3, continue the step 4 to 6 for each training vector of x. So in step 4, to calculate the input unit, we have a formula that is x of I equal to s of I, where I will be ranging from 1 to n. For step 5, to calculate the net input, we have a formula: y n equal to b plus summation of I to n x I w of I j. So where b is a bias and n is the total number of input neurons which you are given. So this is the total net input which you are calculating by using this formula. So in step 6, by applying the activation function, we will be getting the final output for each output unit, that is from j equal to 1 to m. So how the output unit is obtained is by using this formula: function of y input equal to 1, you will be getting as output if the y input of j is greater than theta. 0 you will be getting the output if minus of theta is less than or equal to y input of j less than or equal to theta. Minus of 1 if y input of j is less than minus of theta. So in the step 7, we need to adjust the weight and bias for x equal to 1 to n and then j equal to 1 to m. So we need to adjust the weight in these categories, and then based upon that we have derived case 1 and case 2. If y of j is not equal to t of j, then the weight, new weight, is calculated using this formula: w of ij of old plus alpha of t of j x of i, and then new bias is calculated by adding the old bias plus alpha of t of j. And case 2, if y of j equal to t of j, then new weight equal to old weight, and then new bias equal to old bias if the condition is of y of j is t of j. So y is the actual output and then t is the desired or targeted output. In the step 6, we need to test for the stepping condition is true or true, which will happen and if there is no change in the weight. So next topic we are going to discuss about the adaptive linear neuron. which will be probably called as adeline. Adeline, which stands for adaptive linear neuron, it is a network having a single linear input, the single linear unit. It was developed by Widrow and Hall in 1960. So some of the points about the adeline which you are going to discuss is about it follows the bipolar activation function, and then it uses the delta rule for training to minimize the mean squared error, that is an acronym of MSE, where the actual output and the desired target output, that is a difference, that is MSE is between the actual output and the desired target output, and then we can adjust the weight and bias. So this is about the adaptive linear neuron. So in the architecture about the adaptive linear neuron or adeline, which we say that it consists of similar elements which is present in the perceptron, and addition with the perceptron we have a extra feedback loop which help to compare our actual output with the desired target output. So that's the work we are doing with in the adeline extra. We are providing the feedback loop. After comparison on the bias of training algorithm, the weight and bias will be updated. So that depends upon the feedback which are retrieved after the output. Then the comparison takes place to adjust the bias and then the weight. So this is about the architecture of adeline. So up to this, it will be same as the perceptron. The extra we are given as the feedback. So this is the extra layer which have been added here. So that's the difference between the perceptron and the adeline architecture. So after getting the activation function's output, we are just comparing with the target output. So if there is a deviation, then we'll be adjusting the weight and bias. So that's what happened in the adeline architecture. Other than that, everything are same as like that of perceptron. And then the training algorithm for adeline, we need to initialize the weight, bias and learning rate. For a simple calculation, we need to set up bias and then weight to be as 0 and the learning rate to be as 1. We need to continue the step 3 to 8 until the stopping condition is not true. In the step 3, again we need to continue 4 to 6 for each bipolar training pair, S and T. In step 4, for calculating the input unit, we have a formula x of I equal to s of I, where I will be ranging from 1 to n. For step 5, to calculate the net input relation y of n, the formula is b plus summation of I tends to n x of I w of I. Where step 6, with the activation function to obtain the final output y in equal to 1 if the function matches with y input of is greater than or equal to 0, minus 1 if it received as y input is less than 0. In step 6, based upon this, we are going to adjust the weight and bias. So case 1 is about y is not equal to t. So the formula need to be followed is new weight equal to old weight plus alpha of t minus of y input of x of I. And then new bias will be calculated by adding the old bias plus alpha of t minus of y input. In case 2, if y is equal to t, then new weight equal to old weight. New bias equal to old bias. Y is the actual output and t is the desired target output. In step 6, we need to step for the test for the testing condition, which will happen when there is no change in weight. So this is about the training algorithm which we followed in the adeline. So next we are going to discuss about MADELINE, so which is a multiple adaptive linear neuron. So in this MADELINE, we will be which stands for multiple adaptive linear neuron. So it consists of many adelines in parallel, it will have a single output unit only. It is like a multi-layer perceptron. So multiple adaptive linear neuron is similar to multi-layer perceptron, where adeline will access the hidden input, hidden unit between the input and then the MADELINE layer. So the weight and bias between the input and adeline layers, as we have seen in the adeline architecture, they are adjustable. So what we have seen in the previous of adeline architecture, we can adjust the weight and then the bias values which you are giving in the input layers, and then the Adeline and Madeline layers have a fixed weight and a bias of 1. So the values of the Adeline and Madeline layers will be having the fixed weights and then the bias of 1. Training can be done based upon the delta rule. So next we are going to see about the Madeline architecture. So this architecture consists of n neurons of input layer and m neurons of the Adeline layer and 1 neuron of a Madeline layer, where the Adeline layer is considered to the hidden layer and it is between the input layer and an output layer. So that is what they are saying, that Madeline is a between the Adeline layer can be considered as hidden, and then the Madeline will be as between the input and output layer, Madeline layer will be there. So this is the architecture for the Madeline networks. So here we will be giving as the bias input will be given as a input at last to the Y that is in the network which I have shown. So this is about the overall architecture of Madeline. X is your input vectors, and then this is about the they are saying that between the input layer and then the output layer, between the input layer and an output layer, in between is your Madeline layer. So this is your Madeline layer, and then the weights are adjustable, and then the bias values which have been set as always as 1, based upon that we will be getting the target output. So this is about the Madeline architecture. So and then we have a training algorithm. The training algorithm, as we have said, that the same step 1 with weight, bias and linear rate, we need to initialize it with the 0, and then step 2 to be continued up to step 3 to step 8 until the stepping condition is not true. Step 3 we need to continue the step step 4 to 6 with the bipolar training pair S is to T. In step 4 we need to activate the input based upon the formula X of I equal to S of I, where I equal to 1 to N. In step 5 obtain the net input at each hidden layer. So in at each hidden layer we will be calculating the net input value, that is Q input of J equal to B of J plus summation of N X of I W of I J, where I J range will be from 1 to M. And then in step 6 we need to apply the activation function to obtain the final output of the Adeline and then Madeline layer. So f of x activation function, f of x equal to 1 if x is greater than or equal to 0, minus 1 it will be as if x is less than 0. Output at the hidden Adeline unit is based upon the formula qj equal to function of activation function of q input of j, and then final output will be as y equal to function of y input, that is y input of j equal to b naught plus summation of j equal to 1 to m q of j v of j. And then in step 6, if we have any error, we need to adjust the weight. So when we adjust the weight, in the case 1, we need to follow y is not equal to t and t equal to 1. Then the formula will be as y of j of nu, w of j of nu, that is nu weight equal to old weight plus alpha of 1 minus of q input of j, xi, and then b of j, new bias equal to old bias plus alpha of 1 minus of q input of j. And then in case 2, if y is not equal to t and then t equal to minus 1, then we need to follow this formula. And then in case 3, if y equal to t, then there should not be any change in weights. In step 8, we need to stop the condition. We need to test for stopping condition until there is no change in the weight or in the height, or the height of the weight should be changed during the training when it is smaller than the specified tolerance. If there is any changes in the output with the specified targeted output, if there is any changes, then we need to redo this algorithm by changing the weight. So this is what happened in the training algorithm of Madeline. Thank you.